Welcome everyone, my name is Paula Phillips, also known as Journal Artista, and I thought I'd take some time to go over the packing tape transfer using stencil. So in front of me I have a 6x6 stencil made by the Crafters Workshop. It's called Blazonry, designed by Julie Faye Van Balzer. And underneath that I have a magazine image cut out from the magazine called Real Simple. For this technique, I do like to use this particular magazine or magazine similar to this because the paper inside is very much matte. Some of the magazines, you know, especially fashion magazines, for instance, the paper is a little bit shiny, and I find that the transfer technique, it's a little bit more difficult when you're using glossy paper. It's harder to get the paper up from the tape after you soak it. So anyways, I've got a couple of strips of packing tape already down on this design. I'm just using this packing tape. It's your regular stuff. It's pretty cheap. It's very thin. So because it's thin, because the packing tape is thin, and the stencil design that I chose has thinner lines, I am making sure I overlap by a good 3/4 of an inch. So you want to start at one edge of your stencil and work up. So this is the third piece that I've already put down. But as you layer each piece of packing tape, you want to go in with your finger or maybe the, you know, a cap or bone folder, something like that. You can kind of just outline the edges of the stencil. You're just burnishing it down a little bit so that you don't have any bubbles, and I want to make sure that the image is fully shown once it's gone through water. So you don't have to tape the entire stencil if you don't want to, especially if you're using some 12x12 stencils or 8x10 or whatever you got. Maybe you don't want to use the whole thing. So I'm just going to show you. I've got 3 layers of tape, and from maybe about 4 inches, for a total of 4 inches up this stencil. And beside me here, I just got a little bucket of water. I'm going to peel this off my nonstick mat. I'll throw it a little bit closer for you. If you flip it over, maybe not in this light, there you go. You want to make sure you're able to see those indents from the stencil. That means that your paper is stuck well enough. So I'm just going to throw this in my little water container over here. And I like to use warm water. Obviously it speeds up the process a little bit quicker, but if I'm doing a mass, you know, multiple stencils or multiple transfers at a time, I just get out the bathtub. Yes, get out of the bathtub first, and then you can throw all your stencils in afterwards. Alright, so while that one's soaking, I did use the Echo stencil, also by the Crafters Workshop and designed by the wonderful Julie Faye Van Balzer. So as you can see, I did this one a little bit before. It's not completely covered with tape. I do have a couple of inches over here and an inch and a bit at the bottom. So I'm going to bring this up a little bit. You can see those white spots right here, not quite done. So that means that I could take a little bit more water or put it back into your bath or bucket or whatever you're using to remove the paper. But it's important to get all those little white pieces off. Well, I shouldn't say that. If you want to leave some of those white pieces on, then that is fine. When you put this on top of your page or whatever mixed media project you're working on, it'll be a little bit more opaque in that area, but I like it to be completely translucent, because what this technique does is transfers the ink from the magazine image onto your packing tape. So it doesn't have to be completely done, but the more paper you leave on, the less likely it's going to stick on your page as well. The stickiness of the tape is not affected necessarily by the print or the ink from the magazine, except when you have real big spaces. The odd time it might peel up, or might bubble. But no worries, you can just get out some gel medium, some matte medium, throw it down there if that type of thing bothers you. If you're worried about painting on top of these images, and guys, I'm just working, rubbing off these last bits of paper around here. If you're worried about painting on top of the images, I've had no problem as long as you let the paint dry in between putting, other layers. So my problem was, oh, I put this down on my page, I slapped a layer of paint on there, and because I couldn't use my heat gun, or I didn't want to use my heat gun because I didn't want to completely melt the tape, I was a little bit rushed, a little bit eager, and you know, it wasn't dry, and then it started, not necessarily bubbling isn't the right word, but it started peeling, and it was just a disaster. So I know it's hard, but sometimes you have to have patience. So I'm still waiting for that guy to soak. When I did this one, I did leave a couple of an inch or so on the edge of the stencil so I can pull it back. Now, because this was such a large stencil and I wanted to complete almost the entire image, I did overlap this tape by at least half an inch because I was hoping that you could get it off in all one pull. Now, there are times when that doesn't happen. Maybe there's some paint left over on your stencil, if you're like me and never clean your stencils, and that might tear your tape, but I wouldn't worry about it. This is one of those techniques like most mixed media techniques that you have to be prepared that it might just not turn out. And if it doesn't turn out, try it again. All right. So I'm just, there we go. Now, I could do this, pull it back real quick because this particular stencil has thicker lines than others. I wouldn't suggest pulling it back that quickly if you had a stencil, excuse me while I use my arm here. You know, if you had a stencil that had fine details, you don't want to rip your stencil, especially if you have some really good quality. I'd use my muscles for that bad boy. Especially if you use some high quality tape, it might be stuck on there pretty well. Alright, so you can see here there's some white parts and there's some water. I'm just going to try to use a towel over here to blot off some water. This is a clean towel. Well, there might have some dog fur on there, but let's not talk about that. I'm just going to dab it off. Alright, so once it's dry, pretty much dry, it's ready to go on top of your art journal page or mixed media project. So here I have one that's partially done. It's more of a background. So now I can take this completed transfer. Oh, look, that'll fit right over that one. So I'm just going to lay this down here. I probably could have waited a couple more minutes to make sure that packing tape was completely dry before I put it down. But for the sake of timing, we just threw it down. So I'm going to use a little bit of a brayer here to flatten it out. Just take your time and put it down carefully so you don't get too many bubbles. Now see, I have a whole bunch of leftover at the top and the bottom. Just cut that off with some scissors. Sometimes you may have more image over here or more transfer that you want to use. So off camera I will take that off. So that page that I transferred onto there, it had some type of flowers. Excuse the glare. But I just love how it layers. When you do a packing tape transfer, because it's translucent, you'll be able to see the layers that you have underneath as well through the transfer. Okay, let's go back to this, see if it's dry. Sometimes you can get lucky and completely pull off your image. It seems to work especially with the 12x12 stencils because there isn't that much paper. It didn't work because I didn't leave it in didn't leave it in long enough. But sometimes you can pull this off gently and get a negative image, which has some cool results. So yet again, it doesn't matter if you had a whole bunch of paper left on there. This means it might cost you, might mean a little bit more physical labor to peel it back off. And it's plastic tape and a plastic stencil. So as long as you have it overlapped by a good half, your tape is overlapped by a good half of an inch, you don't necessarily have to be gentle with it at this point. So I'm just rubbing and rubbing and trying to get all the tape off. And if you don't want to rub it, throw it back into the water, let it do its thing. Alright, there is some on lots of paper, as you can see on the edge over here. So I can already see my giraffe peeking through. I guess there's some zebras over there. So anyways, just making sure that the paper is all gone. And I'm just using a paper towel to dry it off a little bit. And let's see. Oh, there we go. So now you can just peel the stencil back. Again, be cognizant of what type of stencil you're using. I don't want you to rip your stencil trying to this technique. But look at how easy that came off. And how translucent that is. I absolutely love this technique, especially when you have stencils that have really big areas. Alright, I've got water everywhere. Another good reason why to do this in why it's nice to do this in the bathtub. Maybe not while you're in the bathtub, but anyway, you know what I mean. You don't have all this mess everywhere afterwards. So really simple, and we can find let's see if I can find a page to drop that on. All right, here we go. Here's a background that I created not too long ago. A couple of other designs by Julie Faye Van Balzer in the Crafter's Workshop. The arrow and that one. So now you can choose to use the magazine image, you know, on the either side that doesn't have the stencil or not. I can just easily, maybe not, let's just easily cut this off. A little bit more. I thought I could just rip it, but because the tape is overlapped, you can't easily rip it where it's overlapped. Alright. Anyways, long story short. Now I can put this in my journal, and you do have a once or twice time to readjust, or you can adjust it once or twice, and then you can choose to leave that down there or not. But I absolutely love, hope you don't guys don't see a shadow in there, the when you're using a packing tape transfer, I mean, the ideas are absolutely unlimited. Here's another example using a chevron stencil. This one just happened to be a very light magazine image. This is where I used, in my last Ustream, I did this background. This is also using the Echo stencil. I absolutely love the Echoes. It's a flower, but it's like not, I don't know what it is, Julie, but I absolutely love that one. And on top, I did the magazine packing tape transfer with the pomegranate stencil. And I thought I had another book. Oh, I guess I do, but I used the, here I used the Celtic knot on top. And lastly, similar stencil, different image. This one actually happened to be an image of some scallops and shrimp or something. But I do like how it looks over top of that. So again, guys, real quick and easy technique. Play around with it. Make sure your tape is overlapping quite a bit when you're using thinner stencils. Excuse me, designs that have thinner lines. And I'd love to see what you create. Thanks for watching, everybody. Much love.